Amjanong has been located here at least for 6,000 years. The carbon dating takes us back 6,000 years. The name Amjanong, the place where the spirit of the water lives, we're responsible for that. Lake Huron drains into the St. Clair River at the border between Ontario and Michigan, Canada, United States, and that's where the city of Sarnia is. Directly south of the city of Sarnia is what we know as Chemical Valley, and that's made up of a number of huge chemical corporations. And then there's Amjanong, which is sandwiched in between the main Chemical Valley complex and the three or four industries after that. So we are bounded in three directions by industry, and our western boundary is the St. Clair River, but on the other side of the St. Clair River is a big hydro plant. It's not an actual valley, it's just that everything kind of flows into Chemical Valley, and that's kind of how the community was built.
These plants here were rubber facilities, were solvent producers. So these workers had lots of benzene exposure, perchloroethylene.
There was formaldehyde, urea.
There's mercury, there's arsenic,
the lead, PCBs, polychlorine.
Nickel hydroxide, material they use for cell phone batteries and
there was
paint
a leak
coatings.
Down the road here. It smelled like propane.
He said to me, I'm having a hard time breathing today.
Since I had children, we had three major evacuations.
She said it was hydrogen sulfide. You might smell it once, and maybe your second time you don't smell no more.
In a perfect world, you would not have located plants so close to the native reserve, so close to the community, and on the river.
The concern, of course, is that you don't have all this exposure and no effect. One of the first things that became a big concern was that the birth ratio of boys to girls had really changed. We found almost twice as many girls being born as boys. It certainly, in wildlife studies and in fish studies, this is one of the markers of endocrine disruption. So something is going on.
There are a whole series of chemicals which act as though they were hormones. Now, the particular concern around endocrine disruptors is that the development of the fetus is under the control of hormones. And if you start getting these kinds of chemicals into the environment, into a woman, and into a fetus, it will go and interfere with all these developmental processes, particularly having effects on neurological development, on the immune system, and on the differentiation of the sexes between males and females.
The normal trend is that there may be a slight higher amount of males being born than females, but we're seeing 2-to-1 ratio of females to males being born here.